Welcome students. Today we will see the new topic, that is Bartholin's abscess. Bartholin gland, you must be knowing anatomy, where it is situated in the labia majora. So in the labia, this gland is of just 1 to 4 centimeters, and it is situated in medially, where it has got ducts. It is on both the sides of labia. It is, the duct opens into both the sides of labia. Now what is a normal, this is the anatomy and physiology. Bartholin gland secretes the certain secretions which will lubricate the vagina and keeping the vagina moist. Even it is helpful during the sexual intercourse. Now this Bartholin gland has got its, while having its normal physiology, sometime if there are certain ascending infection from the vulva, this Bartholin gland may get affected. Due to this ascending infections, the inflammation of the gland occurs and it is presented in the form of acute bartholinitis. This inflammation of acute bartholinitis is sometimes presented by pain in the vulva. Now, bartholinitis, when it is not treated in time, it may cause chronic bartholinitis. Acute is already occurring. It may cause chronic bartholinitis. It may also cause cyst in the Bartholin gland, that is called as Bartholin cyst. Now if this Bartholin cyst is superimposed by some bacteriological infections, then Bartholin abscess is formed. So we will see Bartholinitis and Bartholin cyst together. Clinically these two, three are taken as same, but actually when inflammation of Bartholin gland is superadded with the infection by some organisms which we will be looking afterwards, so it is the suppurative condition of the Bartholin gland. So suppuration means naturally collection of pus in it. What exactly happens when this duct has to secrete due to inflammation, again towards the bartholinitis, this duct causes, Bartholin gland is inflamed and there is exudative discharge within the duct. Now if the discharge is, so we will see that some redness and swelling in the labia. Now if we press it, sometimes red areola is formed here. If we press the part which is tender, so it shows pain and tenderness, and if we press more, it will give the discharge. So discharge will come out of the Bartholin duct into the labia. So this is how the pathology of Bartholinitis and Bartholin cyst occurs. Now sometimes this exudative discharge is not secreted due to ascending infections and some mucus plugs are there. This duct gets blocked there. Once the duct gets blocked, then this may cause the Bartholin cyst. So Bartholin gland cyst, when it forms, till that time it's okay. Patient is experiencing occasionally symptoms, sometimes she is symptomless. But if she is presenting symptom, it may be pain, swelling, redness at the point, areola is formed, red areola around the point, induration, tenderness. Now if pus forming has occurred, so what we are looking, this Bartholin abscess is the common pathological condition in reproductive age group of women. We see that 2% of the female in the reproductive age group suffer at some point in her married life, in her reproductive age. So 2%. So practically we see lot of the cases, some are presenting with small cysts, some are with larger cysts, some are with very minor symptoms, some are with acute symptoms. So causative organisms is aerobes, anaerobes, it is also polymicrobial. Then sexually transmitted infection is not so commonly occurring in Bartholin, but it may occur, that is chlamydia, gonorrhea and other. So this is suppuration of either cyst or gland itself is getting suppurated. So pus forming lesion and pus is accumulated inside. That is how I think you understood what is exactly Bartholin abscess. How a woman is going to present? She may come with swelling of the vulva, which is usually unilateral. Gland is bilaterally situated, but we see commonly the condition is on one side of the vagina. So swelling is a very common symptom. Due to this swelling, she will always complain of, if it is larger swelling, she will complain of difficulty in walking, in sitting down, as well as difficulty due to discomfort in sexual intercourse. Sometimes she may experience with pain during swelling. And of course, as it is an infection due to some anaerobic and aerobes lesions by organisms, there is inflammation and all, fever will always be there. This is how the symptoms. Now we'll see signs. Yes, coming to signs. After looking for symptom, we will have to see the signs. Signs, temperature ki sign kya rahegi? It is raised temperature. And due to this fever, we will find the tachycardia, that is increased pulse rate. After that, local signs we have to see. Definitely, per abdomen will not find anything serious. It will be normal. So, per vaginal examination becomes very important. So we have to give the lithotomy position and visualize the vulva, vestibule, vagina properly. This Bartholin gland is also known as vestibular gland, greater vestibular gland. Now, we will see the localized swelling like this. Localized swelling which is coming from locally from the major and it is going towards or forwarding towards the labia minora. It is posteriorly and median aspect of forwarding towards the median aspect of labia minora from majors to minors. Now this is a localized swelling. It will look red, edematous, and it is tender on pressure. We will also see the swelling is showing fluctuation as well as tenderness. Now with this examination and signs and symptoms, we come to the point that this may be either sebaceous cyst or skin tubule cyst, or it may be some lipoma, or it may be an epidermoid cyst. But showing the symptoms of difficulty in walking, fever, sitting, and associated lymph nodes enlargement. Which group of lymph nodes will enlarge? Inguinal group of lymph nodes will enlarge. So clinically, all of these symptoms, signs, and age of the woman, reproductive age group will come to the diagnosis. So diagnosis as such, no imaging is required because cyst and swelling we can see directly over the area. Now, differentiate diagnosis before the complications being seen. So you have to differentiate between whether it may be a sebaceous cyst, it may be hernia, it may be folliculitis, that is inflammation of the hair follicles. And sometime in cases, women who have completed her age or family above 40, women, we should always have a suspicion if the tissue is enlarged. So biopsy is always advised after the age of 40 in order to rule out the vulva cancers. So this is what differentially diagnosis. After that, reaching to that, we will come to again complication. What complication may occur if abscess is not giving or cyst is not giving at all any symptom? Then we should keep the patient in the observation. She will not require as such a active treatment. But if abscess is painful, swelling, then medication, symptomatic treatment is required. And sometimes it may complicate. This abscess may burst, it may rupture, and the discharge will emit out, leaving behind the sinus. And this sinus now gives the intermittent discharges, which is not a good symptom, it is a distressing them. So, after the differential diagnosis, sometime complication, complication can occur, we have already seen. Treatment part becomes important. If trouble is more, we have to treat her actively. We can give a basic treatment like rest in home, bed rest, then hot fomentation of that area. SIDS bath is also important, but not only one, 3 to 4 SIDS bath can be given for about 15 to 20 minutes, which may relieve some of the tenderness and swelling and pain. But if it doesn't work, if medical treatment is not responding, then surgical intervention is required. In that, basically what is advised? Ward has found this catheter in the year 1677. So Ward's catheter. This Ward's catheter is introduced in the swelling and it is kept there for 3 to 4 weeks, which will find the abscess is drained in it for 3 to 4 weeks. But she can do her routine, but abstinence for sex is required in this case, Ward's catheter. Otherwise, incision and drainage, which is very common modality, surgical thing, incised and drained, versus incised and drained. But SIDS bath, we have already discussed. Then marsupialization. What is it? It is the opening, the swelling is incised after the incision. It is stitched like that. It is not closed again. It is remained open. It is left open. Why? The idea is what? The fluid is completely drained, discharged, and the cotton gauze is kept there for one day, where lower end of last end is kept outside, which is again antiseptic, betadine and all can be kept there. So this gauze is, and daily dressing is required till the incision or wound heals. This is what the marsupialization can be done. So these are the treatment modalities for Bartholin abscess. But even after incision drainage or the drainage, there can be recurrences. If a woman gets frequent recurrences, 3 to 4 times recurrences are there, then these in that woman who has completed her family, her age is more than sometime, removal of Bartholin gland is also advised. Okay.